These glacial lake outburst floods started happening in 2011. And in 2011, it was a very hot, sunny day. And then all of a sudden, the Menihal River just started to rise. And us within the CBJ, the university, and the USGS took note of it. And we were questioning, like, what's happening? Where's this water coming from? And so we heard some chatter from the local helicopter companies that there was water that always would fill up in Suicide Basin and then annually and then go away. So we had an idea of maybe where this water would come from. So a team of us went up to the Menihal into Suicide Basin, and sure enough, yes, that's where this pond of water was being impounded by the Menihal Glacier, and it was releasing at that time. And ever since 2011, we've seen these outburst floods take place every single year. In 2023 and 2024, what took place was that all the water that was impounded in the basin was able to drain out of the basin into the Menihal system all at one time. The amount of water in Suicide Basin is quite large. It's about 16 to 17 billion gallons of water is released from the basin on these full releases. And essentially, it's almost like a bathtub or a cup. And you keep on filling that cup, and just water starts filling over the top of the cup. In the past 4 years that we've seen these overtopping events, it's taken about 4 to 6 days for the subglacial release to start. It fills up with water to a certain point, and then through that, the pressure is able to float the Menihal Glacier up enough so some water is able to flow underneath, and that's called hydrostatic lifting. And then once you release that pressure, the actual weight of the glacier, of Menihal Glacier, will sink back down and close that conduit back up, and that's when we will see refilling. Last year, after the event that took place in August, about a couple of days right after the event, the basin started filling again. With this type of monitoring that we have at Suicide Basin, we have a good idea of the volume. We have a good idea of how these events have happened in the past. When you see the Menihal Lake gauge crests during these outburst floods, we've calculated it's about 15 to 45 minutes, depending on where you're at downriver of Menihal Lake, of when you will see that crest. And once that crest takes place, wherever you're at, you will start seeing the river receding and start going back down. High tide will actually maybe slow down the recession of the water in Menihal Lake. There are other external factors that play into it, like rainfall. So the starting point of the Menihal does play a role, and that's dictated by how much precipitation may fall prior to it, but is a very small proportion of the whole event. On the forecast that you're going to hear, you're going to see a range of values for the peak. It's going to be about a half foot, give or take, of what the forecast peak would be. Same thing on the timing. The time is not going to be a single time frame. It's going to be a window of about a two to three hour window of when that peak could take place. Once you start seeing this drop in the Menihal Lake River gauge, 15 to 45 minutes, depending on where you're at on the river, is when you will start seeing that water really going down. But still, we were above moderate flood stage for almost 22 hours last year. Another question has come up on, like, how does a foot rise at Menihal Lake affect my place downstream? It's not a one-to-one relationship, so just a 1 foot rise on the lake doesn't necessarily see that you just see a 1 foot rise in water levels at Meander Way or Killowich or Emily Way or so forth. A better way to be able to identify if your place would be impacted or if you will get impacted from a foot rise in a forecast is to really look at those inundation maps. Go to those inundation maps, go to your location, put in your address, go to that flood level that we're forecasting, and just see if you're inundated. If you hover over your area, you will see the flood depths too. So you will be able to see at how deep the water would be around your area. But if you go to the Weather Service Suicide Basin monitoring page, we have all the forecast and the impacts right there. So you'll be able to really identify what impacts you could see at your home, and then what action you would need to take. Could we see higher outburst floods in the future? Yes, we possibly could, depending on what happens within the geometry, the ice in the basin. Really, the way to feel or like get a feeling if we're going to see bigger outburst floods is how much volume can the basin hold, and that's really going to dictate if we can see higher floods. And then also, is that release rate? If we see higher release rates with higher volumes, then yes, we could see higher outburst floods.